prize it at the catchweight contest. And if you just joined us, there is the Floral Hall Health Club. The packed capacity crowd here. I think you'll enjoy it. To follow Marty Jones and those great ones. For that left arm to get a headlock and strangle. There it is. Still touching, comes back to the arm here. Back over to the back. Just a lay it on the bed. The arm lever put on. Right against the joint. Gives him his right shoulder. Go back, Evan. Still passing in charge. Doing well.
No.
Shoulder blade's not on. Out to the two. Finally, Miles out of that. Now, let's see how he attacks. He won't allow that to happen again too early. Now a minute to go, and Patton waiting for him. That time goes in for the butt. A little bit late. The body check didn't work that time either. All traces of the sole of the foot there as Myers going coming off the rope. Nicely taken, all very neatly taken. A reverse first over for it, the first double leg. Nelson, beautifully done by Myers. Held match. 2 minutes, 25 seconds into round three. Myers, the first fall. And what a beauty it was. Reverse double leg belt. Your MC, Brian Crabtree, to announce it.
In 2 minutes, 25 seconds of round three, referee gives the first fall to Iron Fist, Clive Myers.
Great move. Anybody of his weight or over would have gone for that one. That really was not Patton's fault. He was taken really by surprise. Beautiful move. Thought he was going for a normal body check. Myers said Stan were waiting for him, and he got the reverse double leg hold just exactly as he wanted.
Take it away, round four.
5 rounds to go as we start the fourth round. Myers leading Patton by 1 fall to none. Now Patton's got to be very careful now. He goes further behind at the end of the bout. Quite so many risks as we did earlier on. Oh, he tried the whip, but Myers wouldn't go for it. It's the shoulder that held. And it's a double arm now to Myers. It's suplex coming up. Yes, all the way over for a suplex. Follow down, cross press. And Patton in trouble. Myers apologized for landing on Alex Kane's back. Nice switch by Myers. That's one of the few barefoot wrestlers in the country today. Never seen wear wrestling boots for shoes yet. The base of spine drop, the side headlock is still on. Count to one, 3 counts to one, but that's all you'll get. Managed to roll out of it each time. Side headlock still on. The referee getting tired of count you one there. It's got to be a stalemate. Just a minute to go in the fourth. Gets in trouble, but he's out of it so quickly. Generally, by staying with the same hole as he's got when he's put in the hole in the first place. So, Pat Patton, there he is, out of Canuck, Wolverhampton, Midland, Livingstone 10, black belt first dan at judo, part-time wrestler, engineer. Became full-time way back in 82, though, and we're glad to see more of him on the screen because he really is an athlete. He's trained to the weight and keeps really tremendous condition, as you can see in this part of his mind.
Take us away, round five.
Round five, four to go, and still 5 miles, Iron Fist Myers, to make a leading Pat Patton by one fall to nothing, gained in the third round. Very often, Pat gets that first hold on. And over the top again, holding press attempt, but it didn't work. Pat rolls out of it nicely. Oh, he walked into that. Green to the finger interlock, he walked straight into that. And he tries using his feet as well. Patton a little mad at that. Oh, beautiful. Caught the mule kick right on the side of his face. Perfectly timed move there by Myers. Perfectly legal, the pole of the foot. So beautifully directed. Accurate move. Nicely by Pat. How can he make something? Double-handed wristly, but it declines so often. Takes him over beautifully across press and trouble for Pat, and thrown off on two. Near thing for Pat in there. He would have gone down 2-0 if he'd lost that one. Take his man down off balance over the further shoulder press and keep those feet away from the ropes. He's got it. There he is, Patton back in it in just 2 minutes of round five. And it's Pat Patton, the equalizing fall, and a beauty.
Ladies and gentlemen, an excellent fall there. The equalizing fall in round five goes to Pat Patton.
A great one it was. And while we look at Pat Patton in this corner, happier man now as 5 miles comes over to shake hands with him. Just a few seconds in time to say a word about next week's wrestling. You grapple fans who are watching next week, it won't be at 4 o'clock as usual. It's the 18th of August I'm referring to. The wrestling will be transmitted at 2:55 in the afternoon. Three rounds to go as we start round six. One fall each. Now it's a question whether Patton can sting another surprise like that. Patton just walked into one of those, didn't want another. Nice quick leg grab by Patton, very fast mover. Yeah. I've been at ringside watching Patton for quite a few years now, and believe me, he improved everything about our team. And he had to today against Marcus. Doesn't he show any proof? One fall each. Putting away one stone, two pounds, not bad, against an experienced man like him, 5 miles. Paul Nelson, what is this against the mark? Two holes in one there. Releases the Nelson, holds the body system. These feet are going to get really locked up now, and the screw gets the advantage from it. No one will ever know.
Red, now.
It's getting counted, Matt. Matt, not in a position to get counted at all. Last thing he's thinking of is going down to a pinfall. He's on the attack and well. Alex Kane, the referee, right back there, watching Myers laughing about that one. And the shake hands means a stalemate agreement. Nobody's going to get anywhere from that one. Still 140. Patton to go in for that, but on the other hand, he's made it with both hands, and now he's just going to regret it. Full Boston crab, too. Myers.
No. 5 seconds.
And Patton held on well. And didn't give on the full Boston crab. And a very sporting contest it is, both men. Also, Myers, not too happy about that equalizing score, but now he's back in the swing of things, and he knows that he has the advantage over the opponent here today. Patton, on the other hand, can he swing a really big surprise and make it a 2-1 win for him over the heavier man? The next 2 rounds will tell us.
Take it away, round 7.
Round 7, 140. And it's Patton winding up with a double hander again. Straight arm left position, but can he do it? Put the one finger in the lock. He's trying, there it is. Trying to go too far up over the top. Nice quick head mare. And Myers nearly had Patton in trouble. We're using the legs each side of the head. There's something turning. He doesn't have the holding on it. Now he's got it for holding breath. Oh, yes, you went past it. Top with the side of the hand, and Myers really surprised by that one, but Myers waiting for the double arm, and it's over the top of the shoulder press, but it's through the ropes again, with 1 minute to go in round seven.
One, two, three.
Couple of near things there. Beautifully brought down, and he's right up the front edge. Oh, a beautiful late Nelson. 2 minutes, 46 seconds. Into round seven, Myers the winner, 2-4-1 by that beautiful reverse late Nelson. Going up under the ropes to get it. Patton fell for it, came in too close.
And 2 minutes, 46 seconds of round seven. The winner by 2-4-1, red corner, Iron Fist, Clyde Myers.
And be back with us in a very short time from Marty Jones versus King Kendo.